Today we'll be pollinating Tillandsia. Okay, let's open this terrarium and take a look. The air plants we'll be pollinating today are Tillandsia ionantha. These plants are in the bromeliad family and are native to Central America, though a small population has naturalized in Broward County, southeast Florida. Throughout most of the year, these plants are a silvery gray color. Then, right before blooming, these plants turn this bright red color. One common name for these plants is blushing bride because of the way these plants blush red right before blooming. Many other Tillandsia species have this same blushing trait. The flowers are the violet part of the plant. You can see the bright yellow pollen and the pistil protruding from the center. In the wild, these tubular flowers would be pollinated by hummingbirds, who would be attracted to the red hue of these plants. Today, I will be taking the place of hummingbirds and will be pollinating these air plants. Air plants tend to not be self-fertile, so more than one Tillandsia will be needed for pollination. Also, plants that are pups are genetically identical to sibling pups, so you won't be able to pollinate these plants that were pupped from the same genetic line, even if they seem like they're distinct separate plants. I was able to successfully cross-pollinate these plants last year, so I know I have at least two genetic variations. Now to pollinate, I will just transfer the pollen from one plant to the stigma of another. I'm just gently touching the yellow part of one plant's flower to the end of the white part coming out of the center of another plant's flower. This air plant is not attached, so the process is fairly easy. If all the plants were attached, I would just need to use a paintbrush or tweezers to move the pollen from one plant to another. I repeated the pollination process the next day to increase my chances of pollination. If the pollination is successful, I will eventually see a seed pod form. Here's the seed pod from last year's pollination. It takes an entire year for the seeds to develop. The seeds have a parachute similar to dandelion and are wind dispersed. I'm keeping a close eye on this seed pod as I expect it to be ready very soon. I look forward to having a go at starting air plants from seed. One final note about Tillandsia ionantha blooming is that each offset will only ever bloom once. Ziggy's cactus channel was asking in the comments if these plants are monocarpic, meaning that they will only ever bloom once, then die. This species of Tillandsia, like most other species of Tillandsia, is monocarpic. But after an offset blooms, it will usually form between 1 and 3 pups, which will bloom the following year. So even though the original part of the plant will never rebloom and will eventually wither away, I do usually get more blooms each year from the pups formed around the original plant. Thanks for the question, Ziggy. And that's gonna be it for this video. I hope you enjoyed seeing this once in a year wonder of my air plants blooming, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye.